Often considered the father of public health in the United States, bacteriologist Charles Edward Winslow defined the term public health as the science and art of preventing disease, prolonging life, and promoting physical and mental health. Despite Winslow's thorough definition, however, the public health community still faces the challenge of defining its image to the rest of the world. Many people view public health as a branch of medicine and do not realize the full extent of the science and art that is public health. Most often, people relate public health to international health clinics, children's health, and disaster response. These are some of the common images of public health. But public health's connections to other parts of society are often misunderstood or even ignored. Take, for example, these images. These are all related to public health in some way. The effect of infrastructure, the physical systems and networks of a society, on public health is one of great importance, and, while it is often ignored, is not a new idea. Aristotle, for example, wrote in his book Politics, "We ought to plan the ideal of our city with an eye to four considerations. The first, as being the most indispensable, is health." And in the 1800s, Frederick Law Olmsted, famous landscape planner and designer of Central Park, recognized the link between poor health and the city. Finally, the father of epidemiology, John Snow, made the link between public health and the infrastructure of London when he pinpointed the source of a cholera outbreak to a water pump on Broad Street. And while infrastructure has always had an impact on public health, the connection between the two is becoming ever more important with the rapid growth of urban areas in the past century. Infrastructure, like public health, is most essential in areas of dense population. Currently, one half of the world's population live in cities, and by 2030, that number will reach 60%. These densely populated areas often have difficulties providing adequate infrastructure systems. For example, one in four urban dwellers worldwide live without proper sanitation facilities or piped water at home. The problem of insufficient infrastructure has a huge impact on public health. Without adequate sanitation or water sources, the spread of diseases such as cholera, malaria, and diarrhea increase greatly. But what about less obvious connections between infrastructure and health? The leading cause of death in the world today is cardiovascular disease. One's lifestyle can have a great impact on the risk of suffering from cardiovascular diseases, and getting proper exercise and nutrition is important. Yet, the design of today's transportation networks often discourages healthy modes of transit. This car-dependent society drives people to live unhealthier lifestyles in over-polluted environments. Likewise, this type of infrastructure design leads to an increase in dangers such as road traffic accidents, one of the top 10 causes of death in low and middle income countries. In the coming century, the world will be facing new and complex public health challenges. The rapidly growing population, especially the urban population, will only make these challenges more difficult. But with collaboration between the public health community, urban planners, and civil engineers on projects and programs that attempt to improve infrastructure or public health, the standard of living for all of society can be raised to unprecedented levels.